Please stand for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
March 18th, 2016. I'm Jenna Thornton.
And I'm Michael Spiraglia. And a new day has dawned on KTV Live, Secrets of the Realm.
Okay, so why don't we explain to the whole school where we are not looking like ourselves today?
We had a costume challenge here at KTV in the morning, and I dressed up in this awesome costume.
I dressed up as a ninja, but unfortunately I couldn't really breathe in my mask, so I had to take that off for this show. But nonetheless, we still are here, and we are still here to present the show to you guys.
Yeah.
So why don't we get into it? Today's KTV birthday is Adam Levine. FamousBirthdays.com stated that he is a singer and a guitarist for the band Maroon 5. He became known for hit songs such as Harder to Breathe and Moves Like Jagger. In 2011, he became a coach on The Voice. Adam Levine will be turning 37 years old today.
Today's KTV holiday is Supreme Sacrifice Day. According to HolidayInsights.com, Supreme Sacrifice Day recognizes the ultimate sacrifices throughout history. These sacrifices were for the good of others. Some examples are when the soldiers in battle gave up their lives to protect our freedom, way of life, and justice to keep us safe. Firemen and policemen have given up their lives in the line of duty to protect themselves. According to ancient.eu, the Aztecs were very skilled in sacrifices.
Today in history, something major happened that would change the world forever. What happened today that would change space technology forever in 1965? Was it A, the first moon landing? Maybe B, Lieutenant Colonel Alex A. Levon in the first man to walk in space? Or possibly C, the first spaceship was built? This event took place just days before the U.S. planned to launch its first two-man spaceship, and the answer is B, the first man walk in space. Alex A. Levon exited the space cap Voskhod 2 for a short spin. Then he completed a somersault. Afterwards, he proceeded to take pictures of space.
There will be a Builders Club meeting on March 23rd in room 30 at 7:40 a.m.
There's no sports.
Sixth and seventh graders are encouraged to come and get involved.
So are you here with the sports today?
Yes, I am. So in the NBA, the Kings beat the Rangers 4-3.
Okay, that's pretty good.
Yes, it is. And then in the NBA, the Hornets beat who did they play? Miami 109-106.
All right, that's pretty good.
Yeah, they're pretty good sports again.
Yes, sounds very exciting.
Yeah, so let's pass it over.
The brackets were released on Sunday for March Madness. The one seeds are Virginia, Oregon, Kansas, and North Carolina. According to ESPN, Kansas is the favorite to win the tournament this year. Following Kansas, the teams with the next best chances to win are North Carolina, Kentucky, Villanova, and Michigan State. The final four will be in Houston, Texas. The tournament kicked off yesterday.
The sixth graders are having a career day tomorrow. So I know that career day sounds very exciting. It gives you a chance to see other careers, so why don't we check that out?
The sixth graders are having a career day on May 17th. Different parents will come in to speak to them about their job. The goal of this day is to expose the sixth grade students to a variety of careers and to encourage students start thinking about their futures.
The 6th grade career day will be held on May 17th, and it's going to be an opportunity for our 6th graders to learn about a variety of different careers. Parents will be joining us that day, as well as community members, to speak about their professions.
Older that they never thought of before. We're going to have a wide array of different types of jobs here, so we really hope that everybody gets to learn something new about a different profession.
I think career day is going to be great. because as a group, the entire sixth grade team came together to assemble a large number of people that have all kinds of jobs out there and give the sixth grade an idea of what type of jobs they may want to have when they move.
Reporting for KTV, I'm Nick Sofonakis.
This day will take place in the cafeteria.
Okay.
We have halftime over there.
Yes, we do. So it looks very exciting. Let's see it.
Yeah.
We are so tired today. We had a lot of tests to study for right now,
didn't we?
Really? A lot. Alright, so I feel so much more energized now that our healer healed us.
Me too.
So let me tell you about this flyer. We have the Clark Recreation Summer Camp. It's 6 weeks long, and you can sign up if you're...
All you have to do is just fill out this form. Anybody through their second year of pre-K or through ninth grade, just submit this form early, so let's pass it back.
That sounds awesome.
I know.
Every year.
Yeah, make sure to submit the form. It's very important.
It is.
Let's get back into it. One of the many movies that contain elements of high fantasy is The Wizard of Oz. This is a film adaptation of the 1900s novel The Wonderful Wizard of Oz, written by L. Frank Baum. Just one example of high fantasy presented in this movie is Dorothy's ruby slippers. The slippers are the MacGuffin of the story because they are what motivate the characters to drive the plot. In the original story, Dorothy's shoes were silver instead of ruby.
Recently, Matt got to ask Mrs. Feely what she wants. She wants to be on KTV. Let's pass it over to him for more on that.
Okay, so I got to ask Mrs. Feely what she wants to be on KTV. So Americo Vespucci's birthday is this month, and I got to ask people if they wanted to, how would they feel if the United States of America was named after them.
How would you feel if America was named after you?
The United States was named the United States of Hull. I would feel very honored and flattered. However, at the same time, I would feel very overwhelmed since it's nationwide and worldwide that's where the name is being represented. If the United States of America was to change its name to the United States of O'Neill, first of all, you're welcome to everybody, but I think that would be pretty awesome. Just have somebody named after you, whether it's a child or a relative, is pretty fantastic. So to have an entire country named after you, the sense of pride has to be through the roof, and I think that would be pretty cool.
I would be super excited if they changed the United States to the United States of Mayu, because that would make me feel really special, and then everybody would know how to pronounce my last name.
Mrs. Fu stated that she would be honored if the United States was named after her. Reporting for KTV, I'm Matt O'Connor.
The person we named America after was Amerigo Vespucci. He was born in the year of 1454.
Okay, Jackie, so I hear we have some very extreme weather going on.
Yes, the weather this weekend is going to be very extreme.
I hear we're supposed to have snow.
Today we're going to have a high of 61 and a low of 34.
And that sounds pretty good.
It's going to be sunny, so that's good.
Mm-hmm.
And tomorrow is going to be a high of 48 and a low of 32, and it's going to be kind of cloudy. Sunday is going to snow and be a high of 36 and a low of 28.
That's pretty crazy for the first day of spring.
Yeah, not so good. So,
all right, see ya.
Attention, cast of Legally Blonde Jr. If you're interested in auditioning for a community theater production of A Christmas Carol next winter at McCarter Theater, please see Ms. Greenspan if you have any questions or if you want the flyer.
Recently, McDonald's employees have been fighting for a higher minimum wage.
The fast food chain, McDonald's, has been in an ongoing battle with its employees about the minimum wage. Employees have been fighting for $15 an hour, opposed to $11 an hour. This may not seem like a big difference, but employees who work year-round are missing out on around $7,000 annually.
We want more and we need your support.
But why do you want more?
Well, working at McDonald's, making only $10 an hour, doesn't pay for all my needs like my car insurance, my loan for my house. We need every dollar that we can get.
Oh, well, I work at McDonald's too, so I guess I'll stay here.
Everyone join the fight.
Join it!
McDonald's employees are earning slightly more than minimum wage, but paying bills and taxes can be a bit of a struggle. McDonald's claims that they have always been a business that pays above minimum wage, which is true, but employees want more. Some McDonald's in Europe and the United States are creating robots to take orders so they don't have to pay.
All right, so we are running out of time here. So for the rest of the KTV News team, I'm Jenna Thornton and Michael Smaraglia. Have an amazing day.